three counter-attack drills that can be used in boxing or MMA. It is designed for aggressive opponents. If you like this kind of videos, please do subscribe in our channel. The first counter-attack is the stepping back counter-attack drills. It is actually used by MMA fighters like Lyoto Machida and Anderson Silva, especially when your opponent is chasing you. From your fighting position, imagine your opponent is chasing you by a barrage of punches. As he approaches, step your lead foot backward and at the same time, release your decoy punch. This punch serves as a confusion and measure your distance to your opponent. As he moves forward, again one step backwards and at the same time release your zoning punch. And zoning punch measures your attack range and preventing him from pushing forward. He will push forward and then one step backwards again and then release your counter punch. And now try to practice it slowly. If you try to practice it with speed for the first time, you might get tripped. The secret here is timing. And once you get the timing, you can see your opponent approaching you and see the target clearly. Now observe my foot and my head. As I go backward, my head also tilts backwards, together with my step. This allows me to protect my head while I'm going backwards. And once you perfected the footstep without falling backwards, you can do this with full speed and accuracy. Just keep on repeating this drill every time you train. The next drill is 3 step backward plus pivotal hook. Just like our first drill, we just add pivotal hook at the end. Pivotal hook allows you to change direction and at the same time knock your opponent down. First is step back and then launch your decoy jab. After your decoy jab, step back again and then launch your zoning jab. And once you get the zone, step back and then launch your range jab. And once you get the range, pivot your back foot and at the same time launch your hook punch. And also you can add power to this hook punch. Just remember your target, his temple or his chin. Will leave his temple or chin unprotected while he punch. Like our first drill, practice it slowly. And once you get the timing, you can practice it with speed. And also, you can include this drill to your shadow boxing and your sparring sessions. Now, practice with me. And for our next drill, it is a jab straight, switch cross, and then power body uppercut. This drill allows you to change from orthodox position to southpaw position and confuses your enemy with your multiple stances. And the first step is, execute a jab straight first to break his range of fire. And after that, switch your foot and allows you to change from orthodox position to southpaw position. And then release your straight punch. Straight punch allows him to guard his head and leave his body unprotected. That makes his body vulnerable and easy to slaughter by your power uppercut. You can actually do switch cross to change position from front to side or in any directions you want. Just like our previous drill, you can practice it slowly and once you get it, you can practice it with more power and speed. Just remember, be patient. And now practice with me. You can also add other punches as a variations. Just keep on practice. That's it. See you on our next training videos.